how, you know, oh, you know, I hit rock bottom and this went that and the third and, you know, my life was so terrible and, you know, I had bad times and good times. You know what I'm saying? My drinking was more of a problem for people around me than it was for me. So, you know, that's the only thing I feel bad about. You know, I didn't, you know, like I said to you, like I said on the podcast, people always say, oh, you need to get help. You need to get help. It's like, no, you need me to get help. That's not, you know what I'm saying? It's not for me. I'm doing that for you. Until I'm ready to do it for me, it's never going to stick.
Yeah.
So, you know, people telling me you need help. And my reaction is always, I need help with what? You need help with your drinking. I don't need help drinking. I'm good at this. I drink better than anybody you know. I'm the best drinker there is out there. I'll drink yours and mine. I don't need help drinking. So it was like, I'm brushing you off. And I know that it was, you know, it was foul for me to be that way towards people because I understand that I was hurting them. And that was selfish of me to be hurting them.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, it wasn't a problem for me. It was a problem for you. You know, it became a problem for me when they told me, yo, you're going to die. Okay, you know what? I don't want to drink no more. It was simple as that. I ain't had an urge to drink no more.
Yeah.
It's like if I see a bottle of Henny, I see a bottle of rat poison. I'm not drinking that.
Damn.
I'm just not drinking. That's what, in my eye, that's what I'm looking at. You know what I'm saying? I have no... Yeah.